car show today and military vehicles and bits and pieces at Powderham Castle. The other side of Exeter. I thought I'd come down and film a few bits. Very heavily populated with visitors, so you'll have to bear with me, I'm doing my best. Just popped down to see Jeff and Jordan and Tyler and Nerissa and the whole family. They just bought a Greyhound M8. Sort of a tank, but more of an armoured reconnaissance strike vehicle, really. They just got it on Wednesday. And I brought it down today. Lord, Austin Maxi. I haven't seen one of them for years. Okay, back again. That's a Rover 800, I believe. I've said before, you sort of know you're getting old when you sort of see these cars on display, sort of classed as classics or vintage, this, that, and the other. When you remember them being just everyday cars. Scary, really. That's a beautiful colour.
I left it too late to put it in.
Ah, right.
The cut-off date was the 5th of June, and I was too late, so it's in the car park.
Oh, right. Blimey, O'Reilly. Maestro van. Originally yellow. So that was probably British Telecom or something similar, or whatever it was called then. Used to be taken to school in one of those, a taxi.
Fabulous. Round of applause, please, everybody. And who's next contestant?
This is Misty, and she's quite shy.
This is Misty. Hello, Misty.
Renault 5. Cortinas. Lovely Aston Martin.
Just a reminder, folks, that we'll have arena displays with the camels being focused on the theme. So I'm sure the motorcyclists have probably been pre-warned, but we will have the cavalcade of motorcycles at 12:15 in the main arena. So that's quite a spectacle, and it's also quite noisy. So for those of you who want to see all these motorcycles fly, that's stunning.
12:15 we'll have the motorcycle into the main arena. Thank you. Rover P6. Used to be taking a school in one of them, those P6s, a green and with a black vinyl roof. That was a V8. She bought it brand new. Well, I should have brought Bella the Jeep down, really, but there was a cut off and we missed it. This is a shame.
It's shared by so many different.
Lovely Mark 1 Capri. Two Cortinas, these are sort of things I sort of remember. Oh, Landy Lightweight. Road registered in 1976. If I do get any of these vehicles wrong, I do apologise. I'm more sort of military vehicles. Thank you. That's a lovely colour. Sort of a purpley blue. That is a lovely colour. I remember when I was really small, when you're talking over 50 years ago, a woman who owned the paper shop in my local village had one of these, and used to see her early in the mornings delivering all the papers in one. Same colour as well. There's so many vehicles here, there's just no way on earth I'm going to get to show you them all. Things. My mother had an estate of one of those. As I said, apologies for zooming through. If I've don't get very good footage of your car, I do apologise. It's just there's so much to see, I'm just sort of cahooning round. Got chatting to my good friends for an hour or so. And drooling over their M8 Greyhound they've bought. These old Cortinas, yeah. Anyway, Adam, if you're watching this, there's your Wolseley. Token Wolseley, just for you. There are literally hundreds of cars here. Hundreds. Bloody hell. Two Hillman Imps over there, I didn't even realise I'd walk past those. Hmm. 1965 registered. Hillman Imp, that was the year I was hatched. I wish I looked that good. we're back. Ball gourd, never heard of it. It's a lovely colour, that though. Sort of like a duck egg blue. MGA. The MG. That little car there reminds me of the car Doctor Who used to have, John Pertwee, back in the day. Showing me age now. Subarus, Subaru pickup. Don't see many of these about now. They were sort of owned by the loads of farmers in Buckinghamshire, where I come from. They all had one. Usually they were blue, or sort of a more yellowy colour. Blimey, 1970s Rolls Royce, about 1977. It's got mud on the tyres. The scandal. Oh, there's Adam's car's big brother.
I went to the air show last week.
Hope you enjoyed the air show. Someone who can smile. Ouch, bar door two, car nil. Certainly got cars of all eras. Start this row. Another roller. Junior Saloon. Beautiful thing. Is that? It's a citizen. Ian Hubnut would like this one. It's a LAN. Lovely little MG. I do like these little old sort of cars with the goggle headlights. Sarah's after. Right, I should get back to you in a while. I need to give my arm a rest. Back again. It's alright, I was here. Oop, that's better. Just treating myself to a period of about the 60s, 70s petrol cooker. Just saw it nestling amongst the junk, it'll give me something to fiddle with. I do like this sort of burgundy, sort of cherry sort of colour. Summer time's arrived. walk through a lot of this. Gonna wander off down towards the steam area. Remember them. Yes, I paid the grand sum of £25 for that petrol cooker. It'll be fun getting it working. Right, I shall get back to you.
Forget your troubles, come on, get happy. Gotta chase all your cares away. To hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day. Sun is shining, come on, get happy. The Lord is waiting to take your hand. To hallelujah, come on, get happy. We're going to the promised land.
We're heading across the river to wash our sins away the tide. It's all so
your troubles, come on, get happy. Gotta chase all your cares away. So hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day. Forget your troubles, come on, get happy. Chase your cares away. Hallelujah, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day. Sun is shining, come on, get happy. The Lord is waiting to take your hand. Hallelujah, come on, get happy. We're gonna be on to the promised land.
We're heading for the river. Wash your sins away in the tide. It's so peaceful on the other side.
Forget your troubles, get happy. Your cares fly away. Hallelujah, get happy. Get ready for your judgment day. Come on, get happy, chase your cares away. Hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day. Sun is shining, come on, get happy. The Lord is waiting to take your hand. Hallelujah, come on, get happy. We're going to the promised land. We're heading across the river. Wash your sins away in the tide. It's quiet and peaceful on the other side. Get your troubles, come on, get happy. Gotta chase all your cares away. Hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready. Get ready. Get ready for the judgment day.
Thank you very much. Thank you. We are the Hummingbirds, by the way. I don't think I mentioned that in our introduction. I'm Grace.
I'm Betty.
That's Edie. Edie's on strike already. What can I say? It was an early start.
She needs more coffee.
How do you like
thank you.
smell coming off these is beautiful. Just getting steam up, I think. Oh, I do love the smell of these sticking steams.
Good. I think in fact you might have to put some lime on.
Keep on about it, it's just absolutely delicious. There's traction engine steam and Willis Jeep's canvas roofs are my two things at the moment. Okay, I shall get back to you. Beautiful little thing. Little models that I saw at, well, they're not models, they're working tractors, but little tractors are sort of Honiton Hill last year. Brilliant little things. Oh, hang on, let's quick look at the stationary engines. go and see what tractors we got laying about. County. Never used to see many of those counties when I was a kid, really. A couple, maybe. Oh, lights, all the mod cons. Nuffield. A lot of the more modern stuff down here. I wouldn't know what half of it is. Motorcycles. Thank you. Yeah, Honda CBX, you don't see many of them about. Six cylinder job. A friend of mine in Moore's Motorcycles in Powell Hampstead had one of those. Probably still has.
Want a picture of me?
Can do if you like. Look for yourself on YouTube. Instant fame. This is a somewhat quieter area of the show. Drawback from a show this size is once you're in, that's it, you're marooned. Now if you're showing, not if it was a visitor of course, but if you're showing, that's it, it's all in and or nothing. I think that could be a Forenza. My memory serves me right.
I should bring my MG up here.
So I'm not really into this more modern stuff. See that little Riley elf over there, look, in the distance. My aunt used to have one. It was sort of green with a cream rooftop on it. Dolomite Sprint, I had one exactly the same. In my youthful, shall we say, more exuberant times. Loads and loads of angle boxes. Made famous by the Harry Potter movie. Oh, and Heartbeat, of course. Good Lord, I didn't realise how big this place was. Right, I'll get back to you if anything else jumps out and bites me. 1937, Jowett, 10 over 4. Old Moggy Miners. We had one of those vans in exactly that colour when I was a kid, called Buttercup. Ended up getting killed by a van in the lane. Crashed into it and wrote it off. An old Rover. I remember when the village vicar ran over my friend while we were playing football. Thought it had killed him, but it just broke his arm. But I always sort of look at these, see them, and then think of that. Awful. He was all right, though. And it just sort of spreads into the distance. Into a load of porkers. I needed that to be some Scoobies somewhere. Jeez. Oh, hello, they've got the M8 out. Let's race across there quickly and see if we can see it.
Workhorse of the war. This is a 43 one. The one behind, I think, is 43 or 44. I'll let Brian tell you about that. But these things were produced in prodigious quantities all over the place, and they just did every job going.
Whenever you see the American films, these are there, every single one, you know, so, and in quite a great number as well. As you say, they must have built an awful lot.
Yeah, they didn't all have two lovely, beautiful women in the back, though. This one does.
What was the trick for that? Great, thanks very much for coming around. Lovely to see you.
You wish you were with me, don't you? Look.
Oh, we have the hummingbirds in the back of us. Yeah, lovely to see you. Yeah, you got the good shot, didn't you?
I got the best shot.
Right, we have another GMC, I believe, here. So he didn't tell us too much about it, so perhaps you would tell us a bit about it.
Oh, well, it's exactly the same shop as Kimball's, yeah. There was 550,000 of these trucks made during the war, 550,000. This was used for pulling the artillery piece, yeah. The shot wheelbase were mainly for that sort of job, yeah.
It's actually seen military service, this one, hasn't it?
They've all seen it, yeah.
They all have, haven't they?
Trucks up, yeah.
It'll go into six-wheel drive, there's a transfer box here, it's got iron wall ratio on that. It'll go anywhere, this truck.
That's brilliant. Like, I think we could do with a few more of the vehicles like this. Certainly when we got the stuff in this morning with the mud. Anyway, thanks very much.
We recognise one of these, I think.
Yes, this is the military
old lightweight
Land Rover, isn't it? Yes.
It's a lightweight version. Lightweight.
Right, this is obviously the military version of the Land Rover, isn't it?
That's right, this is the air portable. Yeah. Half-ton lightweight, yeah.
Okay, yes. So apart from that, is it sort of standard Land Rover underneath, or chassis and everything?
Yeah, standard lightweight chassis, so it's slightly different from the, this is a Series 3 Land Rover, so the running gear and everything is virtually the same. There was 35,000 lightweights made, only 12, and this is a Powderham vehicle, and there were only 12 of those made like this. All of those 12 were different. So its history is very vague.
Well, I know who my star of the show is.
XSAS, so
and
it's
there
quite
it is.
Quite a vague.
Oh, I was
going to
say, you
they're all decommissioned or replica, yes.
Yeah, I thought they probably would be, but...
The bazooka on the front was actually in the film Fury. That's a prop from the film Fury.
Oh, this actual piece of kit here is the actual prop?
Yeah, so that's out of era for the Land Rover, but Ben likes it. So it's actually my son's Land Rover. It's his vehicle, and it's been specially adapted to so he can travel in it.
Fizzy. Blowing around.
I don't think that's a normal way of climbing down one of them, but no, great to see you. Please go and see them.
RD 400. This is what started it all. I had one of these in yellow and black.
And there's a good varied selection here. These GMCs were the standard.
Brilliant things. They were the rocket ships of their days, the 400s. They had the RD 250 as well, and then the LC 350 came out and sort of took over. Zoomed in. Now I'm zoomed out. Look at that, Gorelli. We used to have a Gorelli 50 Tiger. Even got his letters of his name. Right, I think that's going to be my lot, I think. I think I've had a good walk around. I've spent loads of money, i.e. 25 quid. Don't really want to push me luck too much. So I think I'm going to work my way back to the dead and scraggly oak tree, which has become an aircraft carrier for the seagulls, retrieve my cooker, and endeavour to extricate myself from this showground.
Have you still got your Watson?
But yes, I must say, very good show. Would definitely like to come next year.
Yes, I have actually.
You have?
But it hasn't turned a wheel for quite a number of years at the moment.
Oh dear.
Is there
any reason why?
Yes. I need to lift the radiator off. It's leaking off the bottom joint.
Oh, right.
But it means taking the tank radiator and everything else. It's quite heavy, as you well know, so... Yes.
Yeah.
But, yes, it's still in the shed there.
They're on the tractors.
Right, there's Simon leading around with his 8450 Massey Ferguson. Lovely big tractor, those. It's, really good work also, doing lots of heavy ploughing. That sounds powerful as well, the way it accelerates. If you look at the back of this, this whole back end steers as it goes round. It's a nice little four cylinder Fergie, yes. Little diesel engine in it, ticking away nicely. And it, milk churns in the back. You obviously don't see those these days, so they become quite collectible for those who've got kept them in the past. There's a, followed by the white David Brown Selectomatic. They were a good workhorse in their time as well. So it's a different colour because David Brown typically were usually red, but that one's a white one. So these are good workhorses. The old Nuffields. This is a 1060, again diesel powered. So. That's a nice good original condition. and then followed by this huge, great, massive Ferguson 1200. Again, look at the twin wheels on the back and front. That is very useful for getting into some very awkward areas where it needs a lot of grip. So, and then followed by the other massive Ferguson on the back here with the single wheel version of it. And that looks very original as well. So. Nice four-wheel by 2640 Massey. You can feel the power in these tractors as they go round past us. There really are. There's a nice little Massey 550 coming round as well. I used to drive one of those when I was a youngster around the farms doing ploughing, and good workhorse. Nice little Alice Chalmers, the Alice D, I think. It's, nicely restored. Little Fordson Dexter. One of my neighbours used to have one of those. A little three-cylinder Ford engine in it. That one's again nicely restored. And then the County. This is the well-known workhorse of the tractor world. Again, four-wheel drive. Another little Massey Bogie following around. Very original, this one.
Twisting and
okay, right.
And rain.
I'm definitely going to go and excavate my cooking there. I said this over an hour ago.
Another one, Peter Bowles is
got to chat to someone with a lucky
GPW. Then I'm
going to try and do a runner out of this car park before it becomes
weighs 2.5 tons.
Swamp.
Very, very powerful engines. I mean, this morning we did a
so I do hope you enjoyed the video. I do hope that I got your vehicle in it. If I didn't, I apologise. Just that my knees are very quickly giving up the will to live, so I need to jump in the car and get the hell out of here. So once again, thank you so much for watching. Much appreciated, and I shall catch you in the next video, which should be another sort of. I think it's going to be a steam show. We're showing the Jeep at, but. Anyway, take care everyone, and I'll catch you later. Bye.